shuffle, create a little heat. So if you've done this with me already, this is going to be familiar. Taking the hands to the back of the head. Open up the chest, breathe in. Breathe out, elbows in. Inhale, open up the chest. Exhale, elbows in. Inhale, open up the chest, side bending towards the right. Allow the right hand to rest on the mat. As you breathe, press the back of the head into the hands, hand in the back of the head, open up the chest, and then come back to the center. Inhale, open the chest. Exhale, side bend towards the left. Breathe big here, little rotation through the spine if there's space, and then we'll come back to the center. Taking the hands right behind the hips, we'll open up through the chest here, take a breath, and then as you exhale, draw the chin down towards the chest to get a nice long stretch in the back of the head. Time we breathe in, draw the chin back to the center, extend the legs out in front. We'll draw the right foot in towards the inner leg line. Lift up tall through the crown of the head as if there was a little imaginary string that draws you upwards. So here we are, we're setting up for head to knee pose. So breathing in here tall, squaring and moving the chest towards the foot, we're going to begin to hinge at the hips, forward flexion. And then wherever the hands are, wherever they fall, let them go to support the body. Inhale, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, we'll fold. Inhale, come back up to center. We're going to switch the cross of our legs. So extending through, this is my right side. So whatever side you have not done, taking the opposite foot, placing the sole of the foot towards the inner leg line. We'll lift up tall, and then as we exhale, we'll forward fold at the waistline. Inhale, we'll lift, we'll lengthen. Exhale, we'll fold. Next time we breathe, we'll come all the way back up to a comfortable seat. We're going to take the feet and place them right onto the ground, about a little wider than hip distance. So once we're set up in this modified bear sit, we're going to take the hands to the knees and we're going to sit up nice and tall, pull ourselves into what we would call cow pose. And then as you exhale, round through the upper back, chin to the chest, cat. Inhale, open through the chest. Exhale, rounding through the upper back. One more time, breathe in, open up the chest. Exhale, roll into cat pose. And then coming back to the center, we'll take the hands just to give ourselves a little bit of a prop. And then make sure the feet are wider than the hips. We'll drop the knees off to the left. Drawing back towards the center, drop them towards the right. Inhale to center, one more on each side, right and left. And then stacking the knees right on top of the ankles. Let's scoop forward wherever we're practicing. And we're going to find ourselves onto our back and just wake up the core a little bit. So we'll find our way onto our back. And we'll take both legs up towards the sky. Little life in the ankles, point flex. So we're going to keep the right leg extended up towards the sky. Pressing the low back down to our mat. Take an inhale. As you exhale, lower the left leg to a hover and draw back towards the center. Good. Take an inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Good. Hang with me. Inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Last two. You got it. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Keep pressing downwards into the mat. And lower. Hug the knee in towards the chest. Give yourself a little rock side to side. And then we'll extend both legs up to the sky. Again, point flex if that feels good, if that's what the ankles and the feet are asking for. And this time, keeping the left leg up towards the sky. We'll take a nice deep breath in. Exhale, lower the right. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Strong through this lifted leg. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Lost count. Inhale, lift. We'll do two more. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. And exhale, lower. Awesome job. Hug knees in towards the chest. Rock side to side. And then we're going to build momentum. Rock back and forth. Finding a comfortable seat. So three or four of those guys, and we'll get ourselves in a comfortable seat, and then we're going to get ourselves up and over into table. So today is all about integrating breath with movement. So we'll take our hands, spreading out the fingers wide, extend through left leg, breathe in, extend through the right leg. Here we are in plank, take an inhale through the nose. Exhale, lift the hips up towards the sky, downward facing dog. Flow through, inhale, plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Okay, listen up here. Inhale, we'll come forward. Left foot is going to come to the outside of our left hand. Lizard. Inhale, lifting the left hand up towards the sky. Exhale, lower. Step back into downward facing dog. Take the right foot. Inhale. Step to the outside of the right hand. Next time that we breathe, right hand reaches up. Step back. Downward facing dog. Inhale, left. Left hand reaches. Bring the hand down. Step back. And then draw the right foot forward. Inhale. Exhale, place the hand down. Awesome. All right, we're going to add. Inhale, step the left foot forward, drop the right knee. So we're in this lizard variation. This back knee, my right, is down on the ground. I'm going to take my right hand, placing it flat. And then with this left hand, I'm going to inhale, reach back. Lizard, inhale, and then exhale, inhale, reach back, and exhale, tucking the back toe, let's go ahead and lift the back knee, stepping our left foot back to meet the right worm push-up plank, and then as we exhale, drop the knees, lower the chest all the way down onto the belly, so keep those elbows hugging in tightly, and with the hands still underneath the shoulders, press the tops of the feet down. We'll inhale to our baby cobra. Exhale, lower. Tucking the toes. Press up onto bent knees. Inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog. As you inhale, take this right foot. Step to the outer edge of the right. Drop the back knee. We're in our lizard variation. Taking our left hand, we'll place firmly pressing downwards into our practice area. If we're on a mat, so pressing down onto the mat. With the right, inhale, reach up and back. Come on back to start, good. Inhale. Exhale, back. One more time, inhale. Exhale it back. All right, tuck the back toes, lifting the back knee. We'll take a breath, take this front leg to meet the back. We're in our push-up plank. Inhale, tap the knees down, untuck the toes, drop the chest. We are here but in seated, so cow pose. Inhale, Exhale, round through the back, calf. Inhale, drop the belly. Exhale, round through the spine. Let's come into a flat back. Tuck the toes, hover the knees above the mat. We're here for three. We're here for two. And we're here for one. Go ahead and step to the front of your mat, keeping the knees soft. We're in forward fold with the head and neck relaxed. Let the weight of the upper body, traction through the spine. And then as we're ready to breathe, inhale, we'll come all the way up into mountain pose. All right, so we're in mountain pose. Make our clothing adjustments. So in mountain pose, strong through the feet. Lift all 10 toes. All right, here we go. You ready? Inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, forward fold, stepping the right foot back, runner's lunge. In our runner's lunge, check in with that front hip crease, draw the hip crease back. Inhale, lift and reach the crown of the head forwards. Exhale. Inhale, float the hands, sweep the hands back. And the next time that you breathe in, we'll come up into our crescent lunge. So we're in our crescent lunge. We're here. We're strong legs. Soft bend of the back knee. Check in with the pelvis. Scoop the tailbone under. Fingers are reaching up. Inhale. Exhale. Hands to the back of the head. We've been here before. Open up the chest. Inhale. Exhale. Side bend left. Inhale. Back to the center. Sweep the arms behind the back. And then we'll place on either side of the front foot. Take the right hand to the inner arch of the foot. Inhale, left up towards the sky. Again, we've been here before. It should feel comfortable. Inhale here. Exhale, place the hands on either side of the front foot. Or take the back foot, drop the heel, and straighten through the front leg. Inhale, flex the front knee. Exhale, lengthen. Inhale, bending at the knee. Exhale, we'll lengthen. Inhale, bend through the front knee. My left hand, I'm going to bring to the inside of my left foot. Take the elbow, place it onto the thigh. This right hand, don't get too cozy. We're going to inhale it up towards the sky. We're in extended side angle. Front knee is bending. And these top fingers, go ahead and wrap behind the back. Inhale, we reach up. Exhale, wrap. Inhale, we'll reach. Exhale, place hands on either side of the front foot. We're going to step back into push-up plank. In push-up plank, we can choose to drop the knees or inhale, tipping the weight forward. Exhale, we'll lower halfway. Inhale, we're in our baby cobra, or maybe we dabble with up dog. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Breath in. Breath out. Inhale, up onto the balls of the feet. Exhale, we'll lower. Bend through the knees, gaze forward, step to the front of the mat, forward fold, keeping the knees nice and soft. Inhale, we'll roll all the way up to standing. Exhale, hands will come to heart center. We're in mountain pose. All right, we got the other side. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, stepping the left foot back. We're in our runner's lunge. Strong through the legs. Float the fingertips up off the mat, sweeping the arms back. Inhale. Exhale, strong legs. Inhale, come all the way up into crescent lunge. Soft bend in the back knee. Create that posterior pelvic tilt. And then go ahead and lengthen the back leg. Float the hands up. Inhale. Exhale. Hands behind the head. Exhale. Side bend towards the right. on that back foot, shift the hips back. Inhale, bend through the front knee. Exhale, lengthen. Inhale, we'll bend. Exhale, we'll lengthen. Inhale, go ahead and bend through the front knee. We're moving towards our extended side angle. So the right hand's going to find the front quad. And then this guy's going to come on up. Ta-da! We found our extended side angle. So strong legs, don't lose that front knee bend. And then as we breathe, give the fingertips a little wiggle. Inhale. Exhale, tuck the hand behind the back, open the chest. Inhale, we'll reach. Exhale, tuck. Inhale, we'll reach. Exhale, wrap. Now we're going to come back down towards the mat. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, go ahead and dial it all the way down. We're going to step back into push-up plank. We're in our push-up plank. Take a breath here. Exhale, downward facing dog. Exhale. Drop the knees. Sit back just for a moment in child's pose. So child's pose is considered to be a resting pose. So you reach it forward, take an inhale, and an exhale. Knees forward towards the fingers. We're going to come back into our table, tuck the toes. Check in with the fingers before we come back up into downward facing dog to protect our wrists and our shoulders. Fingers are spread nice and wide. Engage through the belly, the core area. Lift the knees, downward facing dog. Exhale. Extend up through the right leg, reaching up towards the sky. Take a breath in our three-legged dog. Imagine as if someone is pulling that right ankle back. Bend through the knee. Allow the heel to reach towards the glutes. Create some easy hip circles here. And then come to a pause. Inhale here. And then as we exhale, draw the knee in towards the nose. Hover. Hold here. Breath in. Exhale. Step the right foot forward, planting the foot down. Back heel. Bring it to about 45 degrees, setting up for warrior one. Inhale, the chest will rise up, so a little different from our crescent lunge or runner's lunge. This back toe is going to turn out. So as we work towards some hip flexibility, we'll check in with that front foot. Make sure that this knee is either working right towards the center of the foot or slightly towards the pinky. All right, so inhale, arms will come on up. Exhale, sweep behind the back, interlace the fingers. Opening the chest, breathe in. Exhale, lead with the heart. We're going to reach forward, knuckles reach back. One more breath here. We can continue to forward fold if there is space. Otherwise, we can use our chest right onto the thigh. Humble warrior. Inhale, use the knuckles to pull yourself all the way up into our warrior one. Release the fingers. Inhale. Place the hands on either side of the front foot. Pivot off the back leg. We're going to pop up onto our right leg. Three-point balance. Inhale, open through the chest. Long spine. Exhale, draw that lifted leg in nice and tight like a little ball. Inhale, we'll reach. Exhale, tuck. Inhale, we'll reach. And then exhale. Inhale, reach the left leg back. Step back into push-up plank. Breath in, drop the knees. Breath out, downward facing dog. Breath in, breath out. Go ahead and elevate the left leg, heels reaching up towards the sky. With the toes pointed down, we'll draw the heel in towards the glutes and create some gentle hip circles. Coming to stillness, inhale, we'll lift up, exhale, draw the knee in, step the left foot forward, pivot on the back foot. strong legs as we come up, warrior one. And then as we breathe, lifting hands up towards the sky. Breath in, breath out, interlace the palms behind the back. So we can work heels of the hands together or create this kind of square. Finding what works best for your shoulders this morning. Open up the chest, exhale, lead through the heart, coming into humble warrior. Breath in, breath out. The next time that we're ready to inhale, use the strength of your core and the knuckles to pull back. We're in our warrior one. Go ahead and release the palms, place the hands on either side of our left foot. Pivoting off the back leg, inhale, we'll pop up into our three-point balance. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, tuck it in. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale. Taking the right foot, stepping it forward, forward fold. Hands will come to the shins. Inhale to a nice long flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Exhale, folding. Inhale, come all the way up to stand, reaching up towards the sky. And exhale, hands will come to the heart center. Pause here for a moment in mountain. One more breath here. Breathe in, lift the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Stepping the right foot back, we're in our runner's lunge. We've been here, right? Inhale. Exhale, place the right hand down. Exhale, left arm reaches. Come back down, inhale. Exhale, step it back into push-up plank. Inhale, we'll go ahead and shift forward. Exhale, lower. Breathe in, come into our back bend. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, take the right foot forward, runner's lunge. And as we exhale, lifting the right hand up towards the sky. Come on back down. Step the right foot back to meet the left. Exhale, dropping the knees, we're in table. All right, so we're going to take some continuous articular rotations. This is a functional range conditioning technique for the spine. And it looks much like cat-cow, but it's very deliberate. It is very intentional, I guess. So rather than just drop the belly, arch the back, we're going to focus on starting at the tailbone and imagining vertebrae by vertebrae, we are beginning to round through the back. So starting down at the tailbone, lumbar spine, working up into the thoracic spine, finally chin to the chest. And then starting at the sitting bone, we're going to begin to extend, dropping the lumbar spine, extending through the mid-back, and last but not least, the chin will come up. Tucking through the sitting bones, we're coming into cat pose again. Working towards the mid-back, chin to the chest. Last one. Unfurling through the sitting bones, starting there, lumbar spine. Starting at T12, moving up the thoracic spine, and then up into the cervical spine. Inhale, come back into a nice neutral spine. Okay. We're going to take the hands, walk them forward. Come on forward, drop the hips, lower all the way down onto the belly. Bend through the knees so the soles of the feet are reaching up towards the sky. Take the hands right in front as if you're going to take a nap, but we know we're not going to do that, right? So take the knees a little wider, and we're just going to windshield wiper right to left. Great way to mobilize the lumbar or low back. All right, coming to stillness. some ankle rolls. And then we'll draw the knees in so that they touch. Hands underneath the shoulders. Let's go ahead and press ourselves up and find a comfortable seat. So in today's practice, we're going to end keeping the intention of integrating breath and movement and focusing on connecting to our breath. So in a time that we are all on edge and a little extra stressed, we're going to utilize the 4-7-8 breath, which does take some practice, but I'm going to walk you through it. So the way 4-7-8 works is inhale for a count of four, hold or retain your breath for seven, and then exhale, lengthen it out for a count of eight. So it's twice of the amount of time of your inhale. And the aim of the game with 4-7-8 breathing is to extend out through the exhale to stimulate the relaxation response. All right? So again, it takes a little bit of practice to hold the breath and to lengthen out the exhale. You almost have to budget your breath. So let's go through it together and maybe try it another time. So here we go. So let's inhale together for four. So here we go. Breathe in for four, three, two, one. Hold for seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Now we're exhaling, so lengthen out for one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Awesome. Inhale for four, three, two, one. Let's hold. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Good. Extend it out for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. At least one more with me. So here we go. Four, three, two, one. We're going to hold. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Exhale it out. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Awesome job. Again, it is a practice like everything that we do. I find personally it takes a couple of rounds to kind of get a flow, but it's wonderful for calming down nerves, anxiety, helping to get good solid sleep too. So here we are at the end of our practice. Let's go ahead and inhale, arms up and over the head. Exhale, hands will come through heart center. Gentle twist towards our right. Lift it up towards the sky. Gentle twist left. We'll meet back in the middle. Walk it forward, forward fold. And then back up towards the center. All right, I appreciate you spending time with me on the mat this morning, integrating your breath and your movement. We're going to be continuing on